Welcome to the official YouTube channel of the Silesian Bridge Foundation. My name is Bart and I'll be your host today. However, today you'll have an opportunity to meet our team. Now, I'm going to start from addressing something that has been coming up pretty frequently, which is I often get asked, do I really believe, or why do I believe, or how much do I think that deposits that we believe that are here are still here? My answer to that is that I've been fortunate to see all the documents, to speak to all the people involved, and through that time, I have developed kind of a strong belief that deposits are still here. So if I would have to give you percentage-wise, I'm thinking definitely over 50%. I'm thinking 75, 80, 90% that I believe that everything is still here. Now, I want to introduce you to the rest of our team by asking them the same question. Why or how much do they believe that the deposits are still here? So first, you're going to hear from Philip. He's a guy actually behind the camera right now. He's our cameraman. He's our editor. And he's also helping us out physically here on the location. He was one of the first people that joined our team. Then once he's going to answer, give you some information on that, you're going to hear from Tomasz. He's also one of the first members on our team. Mosquitoes, I'm sorry. And he's our linguist. Also a very multi-talented person, and he's helping us in all other areas as well. Then you're going to hear from Paweł. He's our archaeologist. He's got a vast knowledge of what we're doing here. He's overlooking this. He's a kind of an eclectic character. We're happy to have him on our team. And then you're also going to hear from Mateusz, we call him Matty. He's our latest addition to the team. He's helping us tremendously as well. If you see animations later on in our YouTube channels, he's going to be a talent behind that. So I'm going to pass on and you're going to see some of our team members telling how much they think, how much they believe the deposits are still here. So back to them.
Well, I think that it's not about faith, it's about knowledge that we have, that foundation have actually. Because for me there is too much evidences that this deposit is here. I have high percentage of confidence.
Hello everybody. My name is Tomasz and I'm the linguist and co-operator of the Silesian Bridge Foundation. Bart asked me, do I believe in that? So, based on the facts that I found in the war diary, spending countless hours translating that and getting the knowledge, I'm 100% sure that it is here. But what about the belief? The faith is also very, very important. So I believe this is here. Thank you.
I'm the archaeologist. It can be here. It will be 80 or 90%.
Mateusz here. I'm 95% sure that deposits are here.
All right, folks, I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you got to know, you know, the face behind the name. You know, these guys are on our team. They're volunteers. If you'd like to join our team, as you can see, a great group of people, please join us. If you want to be intern with us, ideally someone locally, please join us. Please join us. We would really use your help. All right. Now, in the last video from under the tent, from inside of the tent, I've mentioned that we did a Georadar testing, which is a ground penetrating equipment. And I've told you that the results were very optimistic. They still are actually. And I'm going to show them to you right now. So Philip's going to put them on the screen. You're going to see it. Now, I'm no expert. Sorry, mosquitoes. I'm no expert. As for speaking about ground penetrating equipment, we call it Georadar. We used Christoph with Georadar24.com. He's such a professional. He's our team member. He's a very supportive, very helpful. He's doing a lot of research as far as how to best interpret the results. With that kind of equipment, the interpretation of them is extremely important. It's even more important than the results as well. Now, I'm speaking as someone that is not a professional or definitely not educated in it. Damn, mosquitoes. But you see the photos, the results. You can interpret in so many ways. We'll definitely see some disturbances or man-made disturbances in the soil, in the ground here, which is something that gave us additional motivation to actually be here and to dig. All right, those are the Georadar ground penetrating equipment results. I hope they answer some questions or give you a better idea. Now, we are at our excavation site, as you can clearly see. Last couple of days were very long, very tiring. We've been working very hard, long days, believe me, and we've been doing some drilling. Now, that's just another phase of our excavation process. Now, we want to do some drills, and in order to be able to use some metal detectors or another electronic equipment to put down in the ground to see what's in there and have better idea of what's in there and how to proceed with it. So these are the last few days that we were doing here, spending at Minkowskie. Long days, mosquitoes are not really being very supportive, or they're just keeping us a very close company, which is very frustrating, but we are motivated as always. As you saw, the belief that we are going to find the deposits is very strong. We're happy, very happy, very encouraged by that. And that team spirit is always here. What else I can add to you guys? Any questions, comments, please post. Please click like, share, and subscribe. You'll stay on top of it. All latest releases, you're going to get a notification. So that's always very helpful for us as well. If you want to join our team as a volunteer intern, please reach out to me. I'll be happy to respond, tell you everything that needs to be done, but help during these videos, during the excavation process, some logistics. We'll need a lot of help, and that'll be very appreciated. Also, donations, if you can, they're also very welcome. That'll be all for me. If you have any questions, please send them our way. And that's all for me. I hope you're going to have a great day. Thank you.